Roller Derby fans, good morning. I am Vince Hannity, joined with Beautiful Banshee and our incredible producer, Big Daddy Voodoo, and you are watching the 2016 International Division I Playoffs, live from Columbia, South Carolina, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Columbia Quad Squad, our host league. This morning, we're going to see the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars taking on the Steel Hurton of Steel City Roller Derby. Brawl Stars are from Ann Arbor, Michigan, currently ranked 34th in the Wftda, and the Steel Hurton from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and currently entering as the number 10 seed and ranked at number 37, the Ann Arbor Brawl Stars, the 9th seed in the tournament.
Yes, and this was the tournament debut for the Ann Arbor Brawl Stars. So very exciting to see what they've been able to accomplish this weekend. And again, for Steel Hurton, just some great battles on the track. So definitely looking forward to this game. Vince, right now, I know that Steel is seeing potentially a few changes in their roster after the playoffs take place. Why don't we talk about that?
Indeed. Confirmed from Coach Dad of the Steel Hurton, there are at least two skaters very prominent with the Steel Hurton that this will be their last game this morning, that being number 5, Hurricane Heather, and number 814, Leanne Grohl. Additionally, further skaters potentially skating their final game with the Steel Hurton will include B.B. Basher, who is not rostered this morning, but Coach Dad wanted to make sure we made a special acknowledgement to all her contributions, Poppin' Fresh and Snarkalepsy.
Wonderful, and a big thanks to all of those skaters on Steel Hurton putting forth quite the performance here at the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs in Columbia, South Carolina. And why don't we talk about our skaters a little more? Who's on that Steel roster?
Well, our Steel Hurton roster for this morning will include number 12, Gillespie, number 187, Sapphire, number 2, Raven, 219, Dakota Slamming, 25, Allie McKill, 27, Snarkalepsy, 333, River Kicks, 34, Necrophiliac, Category 5, Hurricane Heather, number 814, Leanne Grohl, number 82, Bone Crusher, number 909, Poppin' Fresh, 94, The Kraken, and last but certainly not least, oh Captain, my Captain, number 10, Ada Bloodlace.
Yes, and your Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars, we have, as far as Ann Arbor goes, they are coming into the tournament number 9, currently ranked 34 in WFTDA. They are wearing black this morning, as opposed to Steel's yellow. We have 008, Looks That Kill, 1111, Leslie Arnez, 121, Jen Price, 14, Sonnet Boom, 15, Cora Slane, 22, Just Wing It, 24, Jadzia Smax, 3, Lethal, 4, Michelle Obamia, 404, Slamuel L. Jackson, 63, Jackie Obashes, 811, Tara Masu, 84, Dr. Mamesu, and 886, Scream. Sounds like the teams are ready.
It sounds like they've been ready for quite some time. And Banshee, we don't always have them properly acknowledged, so while we've got a few seconds, can we go ahead and introduce who will be our officiating team for this morning, please?
Oh, absolutely. Starting off with those fabulous flamingos, our non-skating officials, led by crew head NSO Momo, joined by Trogdora the Jaminator, Alia's Stoned, Sparkling Wine, Galvatron, Diamond TR, Geo Knitter, Wishbone Breaker, Chemical Restraint, This'll Be Painful, Ivy Nixon, Christy Cuffs, Coconut Chanel, and Goldie Gloves. Our crew head referee is the Panty Christ, joined by DJ Jazzy Ref, PH Diva, Call It a Shot, Davey Darko, Direwolf, Trial and Terror, and Vanilla Vice.
Thank you very much, Manchi, our officiating crew, for our ninth place game for day 3 of the 2016 Division I International Playoffs here in Columbia, South Carolina. No surprises here from the Steel Hurton as they will send out to the Fast Girl start line 814 Leanne Grohl. The Brawl Stars doing some final discussions as far as their jammer. They will go ahead and send to the Fast Girl start line 1111 Leslie Arnez. Not a huge surprise on that one either.
Some big hugs on that start line. Not a bad way to start the game.
Indeed.
Leanne Grohl slicing down the center of the pack, having to go around the outside of the Ann Arbor defense, which sends off one blocker to the penalty box as the pack remains in the front stretch behind the jammer line still. detaining Leslie Arnaz, but it appears a call has been made on Leslie Arnaz, leaving a power jam to Leanne Grohl. That was a cutting the track penalty for Ann Arbor's jammer.
And Leanne Grohl just rolling, already working on 10 points, potentially 14 points on the jam. We'll keep an eye on the updates as she re-enters the pack in turn number one. Banshee
coming around the outside, you know, slicing slowly across the middle, but with ease, Leanne Grohl puts five more on the board for Steele Hurton.
And I stand corrected, that's 15 points in the pass. Apex hop, skip, and a jump. Marking is 20, and she'll call off the jam.
Complete apex jump. A thing of beauty is the joy of forever.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And message clearly sent by the Steele Hurton, coming out fast, coming out strong to establish dominance.
Of course, drawing first blood.
As they like to say.
Yes, that's how they roll.
And they'll roll into a power start with this jam. This will go to the fast girl start line for Snarkalepsy. Leslie Arnaz still completing her penalty in our penalty box.
We have a full four-on-four blocker lineup. And Snarkalepsy shouldering past the defense, bringing that three wall down to two. Oh, and she is taken to the outside, however, not out, able to get past that edge of the engagement zone.
And Snark will get lead jammer due to an out of play as she enters on the first scoring pass. Interesting style that we're seeing. The arms maybe a little bit wild. Hopefully the officials do not call for a forearm on some of these. I don't think she's affected relative position of the pack with any of these just yet. So she's clean so far. She now attacks, trying to go for a multiplayer block, but great brace by the Brawl Stars.
Brawl Stars doing a great job, as you mentioned, slowing down Snarkalepsy right in turn three. She keeps pushing though, quite tenacious. Breaks free just past the jammer line. Big hits on Leslie Arnaz. If you haven't noticed, there's a star stash in progress, hoping to make herself less of a target. Pushing up the middle of the Steele Hurton defense. Taken to the inside, able to hop over on the apex in turn four, making her way around.
And what I did love from that last pass, seeing both the Brawl Stars and the Steele Hurton going to play the offense, the transition game play offense, so important at the higher levels of the game. Banshee, I cannot emphasize that enough.
Yes, you are absolutely correct.
Thank you.
And I appreciate your emphasis, Vince. Okay, getting started here. Fast Girl Skates start line. Tara Masu, first time on the line today. Oh, it appears we do have an official timeout in progress.
I believe the official timeout being our jam ref confirming with one of our scorekeepers and scoreboard operator to make sure all the T's are crossed and the I's are dotted. And I believe everything's confirmed. So, Benji, I think we're about ready to get back underway.
Great. And that official timeout was brought to you by Adam Skates. Don't forget the hashtag ColorMeAdam. We have River Kicks wearing the star for Steele Hurton. Caught up in the mix of Ann Arbor's defense. And it appears Tara Masu walks away with lead. Have a bit of a mix there. There was a tripod in the middle of fluid Steele Hurton blockers. And meanwhile, Tara Masu puts another five on the board. Pack slowing up in turn two.
Coming around the outside, coming out of turn number two. Great blocking by the Brawl Stars, marking a perfect 10 on the pass.
Brawl Stars taking River Kicks to the outside line, immediately to the inside line, back in the middle. Also, as we know, this weekend we've been referring to that as the jammer sad place.
It's a sad place, but nothing sad. What's going on with Tara Miso? She's now 15 points on the jam. And Banshee, what a rally in this jam.
Yes, and that sad place rally ends up being the motivation and happy place for Tara Miso.
And number four will be sent to the penalty box. I believe that's Michelle Obama on a forearm penalty, but doesn't matter. Tara Miso still rolling, and finally out of the pack is River Kicks.
neck and neck. We'll see if there's any resulting aggression between jammers. Nope. Tiramisu keeping it classy with a quick call off, playing it smart.
Well, it was a good good choice by her. She saw Steel Hurton get to the front of the pack, saw it was close. As always, discretion this early, the better part of valor, calls it off. The damage already done with 20 points on the jam.
Exactly. 20 points on the jam. A total of 20 points for Ann Arbor on the board to Steel City's 33. We have 24 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the first half. Gillespie for Steel Hurton on the fast girl skate start line, but it is Samuel L. Jackson in black for Ann Arbor. Lead to Gillespie. Pack picking up a little bit of pace into turn two, extending into the back stretch. Jax free, although not lead. Big sweep on Gillespie to the outside, forcing the call off.
Not a bad effort on those passes by number 22 of the Brawl Stars, just wing it. But the key thing is, we talked a bit about it a little bit yesterday. It's that extra little thing. It's not simply hitting to the line. It's hitting all the way to the line and knocking that skater out. And unfortunately, just wing it, not quite all the way out. And that's why you got that scoring pass from the Steel Hurton.
Indeed. Keeping a nice empty penalty box. Leanne Grohl tiptoeing on the outside line, although I may have cursed it. That was a cutting the track penalty for Leanne Grohl, putting a power jam in the hands of Dr. Mamesju, first time with the jammer star in this game. Saw a lot of star passes to Dr. Mamesju this weekend.
Indeed, first star pass of the game for either team. Star passes per game. Ann Arbor averaging about 2.5. Steel Hurton up to over 4 a game average for the 2016 season. So keep an eye for this pot happening, as my learned colleague Banshee points out, and we're underway with another scoring pass, Banshee.
Yes, and Mames was able to push out that zone of engagement, really breaking down Ann Arbor's defense to one lone blocker, using this power jam to her advantage.
That'll make 10 points on the jam so far. Out of the darkness into the light is Leanne Grohl, as she will finally complete her initial pass with over a minute gone in the jam.
Mamesju up the middle, making it look easy. Grohl met with a two wall, but the Ann Arbor defense not able to recycle in time and catch her as she escapes turn three.
And of course, with the cutting the track penalty and the start pass, there is no eligibility for lead jammer. The jam must go the full 2 minutes with about 30 seconds left.
Grohl caught up on one last Ann Arbor defender. Mams hitting the back of the pack in the front stretch. Some great defensive efforts taken down to number 10. That would be Ada Bloodlace, your Steel Hurton captain.
And the jam will end on 2 minutes. And we're waiting for final score updates. No points on that last pass as Coach Dad comes out to the Panty Christ to talk things over.
Back-to-back huge jams for Ann Arbor.
Oh, indeed. And we're only at a 7-point game. The Steel Hurton 49, the Brawl Stars 42 on that 22-12 jam with just over 21 minutes left in regulation.
Snarkalepsy and Sonnet Boom are your jammers. There's a 4-2 pack advantage for Steel Hurton. Snarkalepsy heading on the outside, realizing not the way to go, takes the inside, forced back out, but it works in her favor with lead to boot.
And thanks to Talk to WFTDA, Snarkalepsy spirit animal Kermit the Frog, part of perhaps her arm style coming through with those jams, waving around, either Kermit the Frog or the wacky waving inflatable arm tube man. Regardless, she's clear for 5 points on the jam.
Kudos to you on the inflatable arm tube man. Pat coming to a standstill in turn three, if only for just a second, picking up some speed as Snarkalepsy emerges. And call is made after Michelle Obamia gives a good hip to the outside on Snarkalepsy. 7 points to Snarkalepsy, bringing Steelheart in score to 56, Ann Arbor 42.
And the Brawl Stars will call their first Adam Skates team timeout of the game. This team timeout, of course, brought to you by Adam Skates. Adam Skates, they just got a lot more colorful, and you can find out more about it at adamskates.com. We'd also like to take this opportunity to thank some more of our sponsors who have brought you all of this 2016 International Division I playoff action, including Spank Alley. Spank Alley, makers of awesome armbands, helmet covers, compression pants, and so much more at spankalley.com.au. And while we complete our Adam Skates timeout, perfect time for one last sponsor acknowledgement to 888. Helmets, pads, wrist guards, 888 has got you covered at triple8.com.
And if you have any questions for us, if you're listening or watching at home, make sure to reach out on Twitter. Use the handle at WFTDA Live and the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. We'll try and answer some of your questions. Or if you have other fun facts, like the spirit animal of your favorite skater out there, we'd love to hear it. So make sure hashtag TalkToWFTDA.
Wherever you're at in the world, in the U.S., Canada, Mexico, in Europe, in Asia, even in Africa and South America, we're glad to have you watching along. And Banshee, we're back underway.
We are. And that is Tara Masu hitting the track against Leanne Grohl. Lead going to Grohl. Able to practically just step over the pack.
Yeah, that was a nice job by the Steel Hurtin' in the pack coming around turn number one. That lane just wide open as it's a jammer duel coming out of turn number four.
Yes, and Leanne Grohl providing some calculated jammer aggression, trying to prevent Tara Masu from reaching that pack. Very smart, a strategic move with a quick call off before any points accrued.
And again, Grohl knew she could do that. She saw the pack, saw the Brawl Stars in the rear. I always kind of question why that happens when you're defending against the other jammer who's lead with that. It seems like a natural progression that if you're defending against the lead jammer, you would always want to be in the front of the pack. If you've got ideas on that, feel free to talk to us on Twitter at Talk2WFDA and let us know about that.
I just know if I had Leanne Grohl staring me down like she just did to Tiramisu, I'd be a little intimidated, so perhaps that was the motivation, but I digress. Samuel L. Jackson taking lead for the Ann Arbor Brawl Stars, facing off against River Kicks. Appears we have one blocker from Steel Hurt into the box, leaving a 4-3 pack advantage for Ann Arbor.
Making now two blockers as they'll send Raven, and it's a full contingent of blockers. No room in the inn. You have to wait in the stables. There's the seat for Raven.
It seems there's almost a tornado of Ann Arbor blockers surrounding the pivot. Ada Bloodlace, who has received the star, taking her to the outside in turn three, cycling back. Meanwhile, Jack's able to break free with another 5 points, 15 thus far.
Highest scoring jam so far for the Brawl Stars. Indeed, for the Brawl Stars is 20 points. Slamuel L. Jackson can tie it. Can she do it? Yes, she can.
And big hits coming from Steel City. We have one being kept in the back. That would be Dakota Slamming, trying to slam through the remaining Ann Arbor blockers in her wake.
And a tactical error by Ada Bloodlace on the initial pass through. Was about to pass the Brawl Stars pack, but did not have the star cover on, as now she realizes the mistake, tries to engage, but that 5-10 seconds was enough for the Brawl Stars to pack it up, Banshee.
Indeed, 5 seconds is a long time in roller derby, as we all know. Seeing the pack pick up some speed, but also become a bit disjointed. It appears we had a back block call.
That'll go on Raven. This is her second penalty. This jam alone, total penalties for the game are now three with about, let's call it, just over 17 minutes left in regulation, and Steel City will call their first Adam Skates team timeout of the game. This team timeout brought to you by Adam Skates. Adam Skates color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates at adamskates.com. And while we're at a timeout break, we'd also like to thank these corporations and companies from the WFTDA and Columbia Quad Squad for their generous support of this weekend's event, including, but not limited to, the 5-on-5 magazine, Derby Central, Roller Con, Spank Alley, Chaya, and S1. Speaking of S1, Banshee, did you know that S1, in addition to helmets, now makes pads for roller derby too, so you can make S1 part of your uniform. You go to S1helmets.com.
Well, I already have an S1 helmet. I might have to upgrade on the rest of my gear.
There you go.
Some shopping to be done. And we're hearing the crowd get motivated. Everyone's waking up. It's a great thing. I love the sounds of derby in the morning.
Indeed, 28 points in that last jam by Samuel L. Jackson, our current high-scoring jam of the game, and that'll be Jadzia Dax, lead jammer for the Brawl Stars.
And we've seen a lot of star passes to Jadzia Smacks over the course of the weekend. They're facing off against Gillespie. And Smacks making it look so easy, taking the inside line unattended. And it appears we do have a passing of the star to number 187, Sophia Fasteel-Hurton.
And another 4 points calling off the jam. Banshee, early on with about nine jams gone, I think the tale of the game so far is that while Steel City, up until the last jam or two, has been dominating the lead jammer percentage, which is atypical as Ann Arbor came in with a higher lead jammer percentage this season, credit to the Brawl Stars. They've been taking advantage of those lead jammer calls, and particularly the last two jams, 37 points, basically a 37-4 run the last two jams.
Yes, and I think a big lesson for the Brawl Stars was taken from the game against Santa Cruz yesterday, where their jammer penalties, although they won the jammer penalty battle, they weren't quite as effective as they hoped.
Yes.
But back to the jam in progress, that is Leanne Grohl with lead for Sturgeon over Leslie Arnaz. A very quick call off. We have 4 points up for Steel City, making it an 81-64 game in favor of Ann Arbor. 15 minutes, 40 seconds remain.
Coming up to the Fast Girl Skates start line, it'll be number 27, Snarkalepsy, possibly skating her final game with the Sturgeon. She'll be up against 811, Tara Misu of your Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars.
Each team starting with a blocker in the pack, although we have the Sturgeon blocker standing. Leslie Arnaz diving right in to the tripod off the line from Sturgeon, able to break free lead. Oh, I apologize. I said Leslie Arnaz, didn't I? I meant Tiramisu. The ones caught me.
Well, I was focused on Bone Crusher getting a multiplayer block penalty being sent to the penalty box and unfortunately catching it past the point of no return, so having to go all the way around. So 3 points on the jam will make it Ann Arbor 84, Sturgeon 64 with about, oh, let's call it 14 minutes and 40 seconds left in regulation.
It was quite the cheerful call-out from Tiramisu.
Yes.
A little gentle hip tap, and she had some fans right in the corner. Again, keeping it a three-on-three blocker match. We have Jax versus River Kicks. Jax already taken back. It appears that cutting the track penalty assessed, leaving a power jam in the hands of River Kicks.
Nice draw back by the pivot for the Sturgeon number 25, Allie McKill, but up against that Brawl Star braced for a wall, but maybe breaking the wall down, shades of Chris Jericho in 99.
Way to go, WWF on us. That's a good time. And it was River Kicks pushing out from a tripod down to a bridge and a two wall, picking up, let's see here, a zero. Oh, yes, 0 points on that, but it was a quick call off, 20 point game, Ann Arbor 84, Steel City 64, 13:30 remain in the first half.
And this is speculation on my part, Banshee. I think the reasoning was she looked at the bench, mm-hmm. Coach Dad and Vaughn Coach were saying, hey, we can set things up with Leanne Grohl again, get a straight formation. It's going to be a power start because you can not appearing on your screen, Samuel L. Jackson mm-hmm. standing in the penalty box. So get a fresh start and power jam that over, but unfortunately, a back block penalty turns this into a power jam for Samuel L. Jackson and a lead jammer call.
Indeed, and starting unopposed is a jammer's delight, but that was a great way to exit the box for Jax.
Two jammer penalties for both teams so far in this game, but that's the second one in this game for number 814, Leanne Grohl. Very uncommon of Leanne Grohl, Banshee.
A big hit from Hurricane Heather on Jax, driving her to the infield, recycling all the way back into turn two. Jax doing a great job pushing out the steel hurt in defense into turn four. Hurricane Heather off to the penalty box, 5 points up for Ann Arbor.
Jammer duel between Leanne Grohl and Samuel L. Jackson, dancing the dance of death coming out of turn number two.
It appears that Grohl is taking the mindset of be aggressive, be aggressive. Jack's like, come on, just leave me alone, man.
Well, I love the skill, the transition with Leanne
yes.
Grohl. She realizes as a jammer, the first thing you want to do on jammer defense is stop that opposing jammer skates, and did just that. Even though the damage done for 3 points, she'll defend the additional 2 points, so it's not a 10-point jam. So pretty good effort by Leanne Grohl there.
Indeed, and very effective in removing any momentum that Samuel L. Jackson may have had.
Yes, but credit to the Brawl Stars on a unofficial 11-0 run the last three jams of the game.
Starting off 4-3 pack advantage for Ann Arbor. Your jammers are Gillespie for Steel Hurtin' up against Jadzi, a smacks of Ann Arbor. Ann Arbor's defense taking Gillespie to the inside line. Slight drawback, star stash for Gillespie. Jadzi, a smacks, picked up lead, working their way through the pack, stepping by on the inside line, Hurricane Heather with her hands in the air, not exactly sure if there was a call or not.
And that'll be a low block for Hurricane Heather, confirmed by our producer, Big Daddy Voodoo.
Thank you, gentlemen. And Pack picking up some speed out of turn four into that front stretch, racing to detain Gillespie. Gillespie able to narrowly escape on the outside, bringing it around, putting four on the board for Steel Hurtin'. Ann Arbor hitting the century mark with an 8-point jam. 8-4 on that last jam for Ann Arbor, 100-68. 10 minutes, 15 seconds remain in your first half.
I'm fascinating stat, Banshee. 10 out of 14 jams in this game, the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars have held the Steel Hurtin' to either one scoring pass or scoreless.
Very interesting.
Indeed.
And on that Fast Girl Skate start line, that's Snarkalepsy for Steel Hurtin' up against Sonnet Boom. Snarkalepsy diving into that tripod braced by Michelle Obamia. Stuck in that sad space for just a second. Manages to juke around the outside as the tripod overcommits to the inside line. Little bit of speed in anticipation of both jammers.
Hurricane Heather's doing the swim to say, you're not catching me in that, go young lady.
She's quite animated today.
A little bit. So the score with about 9 minutes, 8 seconds left in the first period will be Ann Arbor Brawl Stars 101, Steel Hurtin' 68.
Grohl with the power start. Steel Hurtin' lining up to the inside line, playing it slightly passive. Despite a big hit from Ann Arbor's pivot, Grohl able to easily escape it. A brace three wall right over the pivot line for Ann Arbor, hoping to catch Grohl in the sad space, turning that into a cube. Grohl hops right over on the apex.
Nice job by Grohl. She knows Derby 101 says whether it's a brace triangle or a brace diamond, you always defend lane one and you never give it up without a fight. And there we go again through lane one. She's dancing around but finding that space. So perhaps she's found the flaw in the armor as a forearm penalty. We'll send Poppin' Fresh of the Steel Hurtin' to the penalty box.
Sonnet Boom stashed the star to break through the pack. able to break free, pick up a few points right at the end of jam. 3 to be specific, bringing your score to 104 Ann Arbor, 78 Steel City, 10-3 Steel Hurt, and won that jam.
Well, Leanne Grohl currently leading all scores in the game with 46 points and a plus-minus differential of plus 11. 4 of 6 lead jammer calls. And on the fast girl skate start line, it will be number 333, River Kicks for the Steel Hurt, and Teramisu 811 for the Brawl Stars.
Ann Arbor with a wise choice, taking the back line in hopes to cap River Kicks from the get-go. Knocking her to the infield right on turn one's apex. The drawback behind the pivot line. Teramisu getting bounced out as well.
Well, part of the problem was Jen Price came in and Teramisu had to say, hey, Einstein, I'm on your side.
Oops.
But second effort will get her through as she will get the grand slam that will make 30 points on the game for Teramisu with a perfect plus-minus differential, Banshee.
Yes, a big hit, driving River Kicks out on turn two, driving back into turn one. Despite Steel Hurtin playing some offense, Michelle Obamia's braced too while doing a great job in detaining River Kicks to burn a few seconds. Eventually releases neck and neck with Teramisu. Very happy with the results of her last jam, 15 points.
And clock will be stopped. And Brawl Stars will go ahead and call for their official review of the half. But Banshee, the stat line is insane for Teramisu. Mm-hmm. 4 jams so far in this game, 3 lead jammer calls, 40 points, no box trips, and a perfect plus-minus differential of 40. I think the Brawl Stars have found their hot hand this morning.
Yes. I think all of that motivational music in the venue had something to do with it. A little walking on sunshine. It is a good morning.
Mad love to DJ Ito here in the house in our venue all the way from Jacksonville, Duval County, Florida. Good to have him rocking the tunes this morning. And we'll see Coach Dad and Captain Ada Bloodlace talking things over with captains and coaches of the Brawl Stars. Let's hear what the Panty Christ has to say.
Ann Arbor is calling for an official review. They'd like a track cut called on Steel City's jammer.
So the Brawl Stars looking for a cutting the track penalty on 333 River Kicks towards some point during the jam.
And you can't see it on the broadcast right now, but I'm enjoying some of the signs out in the stands from the Steel Hurtin fans. We have the Yinz sign. If you're not sure about Yinz, that's a little bit of Pittsburghese, bringing that here to Columbia, South Carolina.
And just a little bit past them in turn number three. Turn number three has apparently been established as the A2, D2 corner for this tournament weekend for your Ann Arbor Derby Dams. Happy to see both teams traveling pretty well this weekend.
Yes, I believe they have sparkly letter signs, but I haven't seen them yet.
And the Ann Arbor, that will be the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes beer leaders there in turn number three. Oh. Thanks to Big Daddy Voodoo, our Roughneck executive producer, for the production note on that one.
Oh, we're seeing some booty motion on the bench from Ann Arbor while we wait.
Apparently that's Snarkalepsy's warm-up when official reviews go a little bit long.
Oh, well, I always find that dance breaks are appropriate. It's always a good time.
Indeed. Panty Christ talking things over with coaches and captains. Apparently he has reviewed with his officials, and we should have an official ruling from him momentarily. Let's turn it over to the Panty Christ.
After review, due to a lack of information or any corroboration, there will be no call on the Steel City Jammer. The official review will not be retained.
And you heard it first from the Panty Christ.
The Panty Christ has spoken.
The Panty Christ has spoken. Yes, the official review for Ann Arbor has been used.
So still with their official review in the second period and 2 team timeouts.
Yes, and we'll be returning the gameplay. Just a reminder, 6 minutes, 17 seconds remain in the first half.
Slammy L. Jackson with the star for the Brawl Stars. She'll be up against the Category 5, Hurricane Heather.
I believe that is Hurricane Heather's first time with the Jammer star in this game.
Strangely enough, you're absolutely correct, Ben. I am in shock that a veteran like Hurricane Heather only now is getting the jammer start in jam number 18 of the first period.
Well, she's been playing the part of Derby Unicorn. You know, she had the pivot stripe. Nothing wrong with that. But I digress. Back to the track in turn two. We have a drawback from Steele Hurton, taking Jax all the way into turn one. Meanwhile, Hurricane Heather able to escape, lead to her credit. Steele Hurton managing to take Jax to the outside line. Ann Arbor hoping to put Hurricane Heather in the sad place, but she dodges, she dips and dives, getting around, caught up slightly, but manages to create chaos as she passes through.
In the meantime, for the Brawl Stars, 121, Jen Price reports to the penalty box on a direction of gameplay. She will be joined in the box by, I believe, didn't quite catch the number, don't know if that's Jackie Obashes, and a forearm penalty on Hurricane Heather. Power jam, Slamuel L. Jackson.
We have a 4-3 pack advantage. Actually, we do. Now for Steele Hurton with the return of their pivot. Braced three wall turning into a cube of doom. Holding back number 22, Allie McKill, who appears to have received the star, has yet to place it on her helmet. And that cube of doom changes to a tripod. Sad place indeed, courtesy of Sophia with a little shoulder front blocking.
But Hurricane Heather, after that penalty, will get 5 points to bring the Steele Hurton to 83. Ann Arbor holds at 119 with just about 4 minutes left in regulation in the first. And coming to your fast girl start line, Leanne Grohl, number 814. She will be one-on-one with number 24 of the Brawl Stars, Jadzia Smacks.
A little jammer banter to get things started.
Indeed.
Nothing like some friendly conversation. Grohl able to step around the pack, lead in her favor. Smacks fighting against the tripod from Steele Hurton, knocked out of bounds right before turn two, cycled back. Both picking up some speed. Smacks on the tail of Grohl. Grohl's efforts not able to thwart Jadzia Smacks.
And that will be a penalty on Leanne Grohl for a low block, just a little too low on the thigh for the block. Power jam, Jadzia Smacks.
Smacks swept out by number 34, Necrophiliac. But right back at it, hops in toward the inside line, able to evade Steele Hurton's defense. Seeing quite a bit of traffic in the penalty box. We have two blockers for Steele Hurton as well as their jammer. Leanne Grohl standing to be released shortly.
Nice defense on the outside lane for the Steele Hurton. I believe that might have been number 219. Trying to make sure, I think that's actually, 94, the Kraken. Good to see her back after the injury she suffered with the game yesterday.
They've released the Kraken.
They have, in fact, released the Kraken.
Released. But it is Grohl who hips out Jadzia Smacks, forcing a cutting the track penalty, putting a power jam in Grohl's favor. Pack slowing down in the back stretch, anxiously awaiting the emergence of Leanne Grohl.
And not, as we talked about earlier, not many multi-scoring passes in the game given up by the Brawl Stars. But at this point, Banshee, this is now the third or fourth multi-pass scoring jam given up to Leanne Grohl, the Steele Hurton, as the jam will end on 2 minutes. And the final tally, 23-10, advantage Steele Hurton.
It appears that Bone Crusher, the pivot for Steele Hurton, went off to the penalty box. I saw an insubordination call.
Well, from our producer, I know there was a back block signal, possibly an insubordination. Coach Dad already talking things over with the Panty Christ, but it looks like everything's copacetic as he'll return to the bench.
Hurricane Heather, Category 5, on the Fast Girl Skate start line, solo as Smacks has yet to be released, lead to Hurricane Heather.
Hurricane Heather now 2 of 2 for lead jammer calls after not coming in with the star until jam number 18. And great job on the inside lane. Almost, you know, basically a bump and gone right there.
That's a little tippy-toe magic.
That's why you do toe-stop work.
Exactly. Footwork drills. They serve you well. And the pack picked up speed slightly and came to a halt into turn 3. Hurricane Heather calls it. It appears we have an official review being called by Steel Hurton.
We're seeing the official review, but Coach Dad just waved off the Brawl Stars coach. I don't think it's any sort of sexism. I think he said, well, actually, I don't think we need it here. Can I just talk over something real quick with you, Patty Christ? Although, wait, our jam timer is still showing official. You know what I bet it is? He's calling a team timeout.
Coach Dad has a great hat. I just have to point that out. Also, if you haven't checked it out, because we've been talking about the hashtag talk to WFTDA on Twitter. There was a Facebook post from Steel City yesterday, and it was, who wore it best, coach or baby? And coach, dad, ooh, or baby? And there's a picture of the baby with his hat on. It's fantastic. I highly recommend you check it out. I retweeted it, but definitely check it out. It's under the hashtag talk to WFTDA.
Well, I love the time management. Coach Dad realizing, hey, there's only 35 seconds left in regulation in the first period. I want to keep all remaining 2 of my team timeouts in my back pocket because this game's getting close. And if it's close late in the game, I want to be able to stop that clock and give my team a chance to reset. He's been very vocal on social media about time management. And a lot of people have been vocal about that throughout the playoffs.
Yes, and getting back to our next jam, we have jam 20 starting. Ann Arbor sending out Tiramisu up against Leanne Grohl, favored from Steel Hurton. A tripod up front from Steel Hurton, doing some work on Tiramisu. Appears we had perhaps a failure to reform on our blocker from Steel Hurton. They sent 2 blockers to the box. Lead to Tiramisu. Appears we have forearm calls.
That'll be a forearm call on Leanne Grohl. Leanne Grohl now on her 4th, or possibly cutting the track, her 4th jammer penalty of the period. In the meantime, we've talked about it, we'll say it again, Banshee. Tiramisu now 4 of 5 lead jammer calls, and now 50 points on the game at a perfect plus minus differential.
Yes, and Tiramisu really enjoying that. 4-2 pack advantage for Ann Arbor. Steel Hurton taking Tiramisu to the outside, cycling back from turn 2 right in front of the pivot line.
And that will be our halftime break. 55 points. Lead jammer percentage 80%, and no box trips for Tiramisu.
It's a big deal.
That is a. If I'm the Brawl Stars, I'm walking into the locker room saying, Tara, don't plan on sitting on the bench that much in the second period because we're going to be running you hard, and we're going to be running you hard in that second period.
I'm pretty sure the Tiramisu knows what she's in for, but she's doing a great job. Just a great showing from Ann Arbor today. Taking notes from prior gameplay this weekend and turning it out. So fantastic. Can't wait to see what both Steel Hurton and the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes have in store for our second half. We'll see you in about 14 minutes. And thanks again for watching the International WFTDA 2016 Division I Playoffs. Welcome back to the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs here in Columbia, South Carolina. I'm Beautiful Banshee, joined by Vince Hannity. How you doing?
I am enjoying day 3 of our Division I International Playoffs here in Columbia, South Carolina. And we've got some stats to talk about because we've got a pretty interesting game going on here for our 9th place game, Banshee.
All right, great, Vince. Why don't you break it down?
Well, again, I cannot emphasize it enough. Tiramisu, number 811 of the Brawl Stars. 5 jams with the star, 4 lead jammer calls, 55 points, no box trips, and a plus minus of 55. When she gets on the track, Steel Hurton does not score. In the meantime, the top scorer for the Steel Hurton, Leanne Grohl, 814, 69 points, a plus minus of 31. But a very atypical game for her in two aspects. She's only lead jammer for 44%. She's only got lead jammer four times out of nine, and she's sitting on six box trips and a half. Here's the crazy stat that I've seen so far, thanks to our stat book. Coming into this weekend, the Steel Hurton was averaging 4.5 jammer box trips a game. They're sitting at 8 right now at the half. And when you go to blocker penalties, they're averaging just under 21 a game this season. They're sitting at 22 at the half. So the Brawl Stars have been doing an incredible job at forcing the penalties on the Steel Hurton.
Yes, we've seen a great deal of that. Brawl Stars stepping it up today. It's been a tough road for them, working very hard here at the playoffs. But we've seen where their jammer penalties have affected them negatively, specifically against Santa Cruz Boardwalk Bombshells yesterday. So it's really nice to see the Brawl Stars turning it around and to see the effect that they're having on Steel Hurton.
Game at the half, 144 for the Ann Arbor Derby Diamonds Brawl Stars. Steel City Roller Derby, Steel Hurton 115, as you see the whiteboard with those penalties. And again, Banshee, I can't emphasize enough. Mm-hmm. It is bizarre to see 8-1-4 for the Steel Hurton with six box trips at the halftime break. I almost want to ask, who is that in Leanne Grohl's jersey and pads?
Well, an imposter, maybe. No. And Leanne Grohl is out there. She is playing hard. And we all have days as skaters where we land in the penalty box a little more frequently. The best that one could hope for is to take that and correct it. And moving forward in the second half, clean it up.
Well, Leanne Grohl will have to skate a literally perfect game in the second half to remain in her final game with the Steel Hurton. As no surprises by the Brawl Stars bringing out the big guns to start things off with 8-1-1 Tiramisu at the fast girl start line.
Great choice for the power start, as we've seen Tiramisu capitalize effectively on the power jam. And it appears we have Ann Arbor's defense holding back number 34. That's Nick Rafiliak. Back into turn one. Necrophiliac really pushing it out while Tiramisu up front on one leg, no less, able to scoot around with a push the defense from Steel Hurton.
5 of 6 lead jammer calls as she comes out of turn number two and starts her scoring pass.
Pack pause briefly in turn two, awaiting Tiramisu. Fighting the tripod, moving into turn three. 5 in the sky for Tiramisu. Keeping the Steel City Jammer standing in the box. That was a 5-point jam for Tiramisu. 149 points for Ann Arbor, 115 to Steel City. And we're only about a minute into the game.
And the reason why you did not see a jammer on the track with Steel Hurton that game, it was two box trips for Leanne Grohl coming out of the first period into the second. That second trip for an insubordination, now standing up, returning to the track.
And if you're just joining us here on WFTDA.TV, we have a face-off of Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars in black, Steel City Steel Hurton in yellow. That is Leanne Grohl jamming for Steel City.
And now,
a lead to her credit and 5 points up.
And catching a lucky break just as 24 for the Brawl Stars, Jadzia Smacks reporting to the penalty box on a cutting the track penalty. And now Leanne Grohl working on 10 points on the jam, and a great way to start off the second half for her.
Well, having a little time to sit and think can put a fire in your belly.
Indeed, and she'll call it off with 12 points. And we'd like to take this time to thank our sponsors, including Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the rolling skating industry for 70 years. You can check them out online at Rydell, that's R-I-E-D-E-L-L skates.com.
And starting our next jam, we have Snarkalepsy for Steel Hurton getting out their little dancey moves while getting settled. Power start to Steel Hurton's. Met with a two wall from Ann Arbor right on the back of the line. Despite some big hits from Ann Arbor, Snarkalepsy set free with lead.
She'll be up against a 4-3 Brawl Star Advantage pack as that's Ada Bloodlace in the penalty box for a direction of gameplay. As out of the darkness into the light, Jadzia smacks Dunn. And that will be Snarkalepsy getting partway and calling it off for 2 points.
Our jammer matchup will be River Kix for Steel Hurton, and for Ann Arbor, Samuel L. Jackson. Jax appearing to take a start a little further back, perhaps getting a broader view of the pack. Currently 4-3 pack advantage to Ann Arbor. Utilizing a tripod off the line, pivot set as a bridge, or to be able to get out of there.
Destruction.
Very fluid.
Destruction penalty going against Raven, number two of the Steel Hurton. That is unofficially her fifth box trip of the game. She will be joined in the box by a Brawl Star as the jam gets called. That Brawl Star will be number 63, Jackie Obashes, and I believe this won her first penalty of the game for, I believe, an out of play, if I'm not mistaken.
Steel Hurton with two blockers in the box. Ann Arbor with one. 3-2 pack advantage, Ann Arbor. Hurricane Heather on the line for Steel Hurton. Facing off against Tiramisu, 8-1-1 for Ann Arbor. Tiramisu pushing the two wall up into the midway point between turns one and two. Able to escape, lead in her favor. Hurricane Heather, not far behind.
And what I love about Tiramisu on that jam, Banshee, not only getting the lead jammer call, but forcing a multiplayer block penalty against number 187, Sapphire, her fourth box trip of the game. And she'll get clear and call it off, but no points, courtesy of that second effort by Hurricane Heather. And now coming up to our Fast Girl start line, number 24, Jadzia Smacks of your Brawl Stars. And it'll be number 12, Galeski of the Steel Hurton. If you're just joining us, the Brawl Stars of the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes are in the black jerseys with gray lettering, and the Steel Hurton are in the yellow with the black lettering.
Ann Arbor capitalizing on taking that back line, meeting Galeski before she can take off. Jadzia Smacks set free, picks up lead. Ann Arbor taking Galeski to the inside line. Galeski stashes the star, able to escape the pack.
And Galeski doing a great job of taking Brawl Star blockers out of play. It's a 4-1 pack disadvantage, but Jadzia Smacks completely undaunted.
And that is just Wing It, the solo pivot blocker left on the track for Ann Arbor. Sorry, she's got a buddy. Doing work to hold back Galeski, who's able to sidestep right on the apex. Smacks met with a two wall of Steel Hurton, taking her to the outside line in turn one, forcing the call off.
And with some of those passes, Banshee, again, the one thing, one definite thing that the Brawl Stars need to make sure they keep an eye on, we saw it a little bit in that first period. You can't, as much as you rely on the brace triangle and the brace diamond, mm-hmm. you need to make sure you keep that lane one guarded and never give it away without a fight. And unfortunately for the Brawl Stars, the Steel Hurton have had fairly good success finding those gaps in lane one.
Correct. It's too tasty a jammer treat.
Indeed.
That was a 9-7 jam. Steel Hurton outscoring Ann Arbor. Back to our current jam. That's Leslie Arnaz for Ann Arbor up against Snarkalepsy. Snarkalepsy grabbing lead for Steel Hurton. Using those jukey feet, avoiding the sad place, battling that brace three wall from Ann Arbor. Snarkalepsy sees that empty lane on the inside, takes it.
And she'll be on the power jam. As for the second time this period, it will be Jadzia Smacks in the penalty box. This one for a forearm. or excuse me, Leslie Arnez, I stand corrected. That one actually going to be also her second box trip and held scoreless so far in this game.
Due to the offensive efforts of Steelheart, and we end up with a mashup there in the middle of the Ann Arbor cube. 10 points up for Steelheart and bringing the score to 159 Ann Arbor, 148 Steel City. Way to go for Steelheart in closing the score gap. It's an 11-point game. And we have 21 minutes, 35 seconds remaining. Both teams very closely matched. No surprise here.
And with six jams gone in the game, the Steelheart so far on a 33-15 scoring run in the second period.
Hurricane Heather starting unopposed on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Leslie Arnez just released from the penalty box. Drops the star for a second in the stash. Manages to recover it. Stuck in the pack into turn two. Hurricane Heather putting four on the board for Steelheart. Hurricane Heather coming up on the back of Ann Arbor. Wisely calling it before any points go on the board for the Brawl Stars.
And no surprises, the Brawl Stars will call their Adam Skates team timeout. This will be their second Adam Skates team timeout of the game. Perfect time to mention with Adam Skates that coming in October, the new Savant Wheel, lighter, faster, and grippier. Four hardnesses for your best combos ever, hashtag Adam Skates. And you can find out more about it at adamskates.com. We'd also like to, with the WFTDA and Columbia Quad Squad, thank the following companies for their generous support of this weekend's playoff tournament, including but not limited to Triple Eight, Rowline, Bruce Skate News, the Cone Law Offices, and your current reigning world champions, the Rose City Rollers.
Vince, just something I wanted to give a quick correction on our score. The points actually for Steel City were updated after last 5 points scored, 159 Ann Arbor, 153 Steel City.
And Benji, for our followers on Twitter, can we explain for those who came in on the third reel, what exactly is the sad place?
Okay, Elisa reached out to us on Twitter inquiring about the sad space. On a tripod, when you have a braced two wall, the jammer comes up in the middle of the two blockers in the wall and gets stuck. That, Elisa, is the sad space.
And unfortunately for Slamuel L. Jackson, caught up in that sad space, trying to force a multiplayer block, not quite getting it. But she will get the call, lead jammer Brawl Stars.
River Kick still fighting it out, but manages to step around, gets that little inch on the inside line. Peck seems to be breaking apart a bit coming into that backstretch.
Brawl Stars coach coming out to center track to talk things over with the Panty Christ. No sign yet of an official review or official timeout being called. Coach Dad also talking over things with our inside pack ref. Looks like everything's copacetic.
And just a reminder, the Division I playoffs and Division II back in August are leading to the penultimate, the 2016 International WFTDA Championship on November 4th through 6th in Portland, Oregon. Tickets are available now, and you can learn how to become a champion VIP and get tickets at WFTDA.com.
And skater down in turn number one, I believe it's 187 Sophia of the Steelheart. EMT's coming out, but it looks like she'll be able to get up under her own power, possibly a foot or heel or ankle injury favoring that left skate.
And we do see that the track was cleared.
Credit to the toughness of Sophia. Literally, as the EMTs reached her on the track from where they're based in turn number one, she had already gotten upset. I'm good. Let me skate it off. Still at official timeout for our EMTs to make sure she's okay and can return to the game. Also, we need to wait for them to return to their spot in turn number one before play can resume.
And just a quick note there, back to the sad space. But overall, I think today, specifically Ann Arbor, is in a very happy place. Elisa said thank you. So you are welcome. We are glad to answer your questions at hashtag talk to WFTDA. And you definitely check in with us on social media, specifically it's Twitter. There's a live Twitter feed going on. And something else, too, if you're listening to the free audio coverage live from Columbia, South Carolina, it is not too late to get the high-quality video feed. It's only $15.99 for the weekend, and we have a couple of great matchups, some of the most intense games sure to be here today before us. So check it out, WFTDA.tv.
Hurricane Heather on a power jam, now lead jammer for the Steel Hurton with the very uncommon position of Teramisu in the penalty box for the Brawl Stars. What an incredible game she's had. But now it's Hurricane Heather on her own scoring pass, Banshee.
Hurricane Heather getting caught up in a tripod, but not for long. Able to break free. Pack coming to a paused stance right after turn two. Little bit of chaos out there as Hurricane Heather taken to the outside line in the back stretch. She breaks free and makes the call. 9 points up for Hurricane Heather, not too shabby. We are at a 1 point game. Ann Arbor 163, Steel City 162. Vince, do I smell a lead change afoot?
Well, if Snarkalepsy has anything to say about it, bouncing up and down on the Fast Girl start line as she'll take on number 24, Jadzia Smacks, all of your Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Star. 3-3 pack, no advantage either team. Or should be 4-3 pack, I stand corrected.
And that 4-3 pack is in favor of Ann Arbor. And Ann Arbor's defense taking the line, catching Snarkalepsy, who immediately stashes the star, attempts the pass, but it hits the floor right on the front stretch. Smacks getting up on the scoring pass. It was indicated that Smacks was lead. However, we had a call. It appears an insubordination call.
A double penalty on Jadzia Smacks. I believe the first penalty, a back block, and then at the end, the referee adding an insubordination. So that's a minute power jam for the Steel Hurton.
We've seen a few insubordinations in this game. Three, I believe.
Indeed.
That is the third. Snarkalepsy remaining unopposed due to the double penalty on Smacks. Coming up upon the pack, some offense from Steel Hurton effectively helping her through. A two wall from Ann Arbor right at the edge of the engagement zone, not enough to take out Snarkalepsy, but certainly effective in burning a few seconds. Steel Hurton initially poised for passive offense, but springing to the aid of Snarkalepsy.
Great job by Snark by catching the Brawl Star, snapping on that outside lane, coming through turn number four. Now Raven coming in for the offensive block, but nice reform by the Brawl Stars.
Snarkalepsy taken to the outside line in the front stretch. Steel Hurton offense creating a bit of chaos, but the Ann Arbor defense a little too smart for that, able to regroup very quickly. Their response time today is incredible.
And with 181, 168 for 5 points for Jadzia Smacks and 19 for the Steel Hurton. That's going to be a lead change. Steel Hurton up with 15 minutes, 40 seconds to go.
Steel Hurton starting with only three blockers on the track. The pack advantage once again to Ann Arbor.
Jammer reminding River Kicks to make sure those armband numbers are visible and avoid the illegal procedure penalty.
River Kicks is facing off against Lamuel L. Jackson. 404 swept to the outside just briefly by Steel Hurton's defense. Jax keeps pushing. able to stay on the tippy toes and inbounds coming around turn two on the edge. Lead in Jax's favor.
Slammy L. Jackson now 3 of 3 for lead. Chammer calls in the second half, working on 7 points in the second period, looking to add up. Make it 12.
Ann Arbor getting caught in awkward blocker sandwich, although it's quite effective in blocking River Kix, who has stashed the star.
Oh, forearm penalty.
That forearm penalty, as heard from Vince, was assessed to Samuel L. Jackson, putting the power jam in favor of Bone Crusher. As it appears, the star stash turned into a pass. Bone Crusher coming upon the pack right on the backs of Michelle Obama, swept to the outside, picking up a back block call right on turn three.
We saw this at Division I Jacksonville playoffs last year up against Tampa in the consolation bracket. Coach Dad handed off the star on a star pass to Bone Crusher. Unfortunately, got a penalty that allowed Tampa to get the points to hang on to the lead and win the game. But will that be the critical play once again, Banshee? It'll be something we need to keep an eye on.
Absolutely, and keep an eye on Samuel L. Jackson. We will. Able to come around out of the penalty box, putting 5 up on the board for Ann Arbor. 10 points in this jam so far. Up on the third scoring pass, Jax breaking into that tripod up front from Steele Hurton. Not able to get past. We'll see if any additional points are added. Oh, it's a 4-point game. 4 points on that jam for Steele City. 13 for Ann Arbor. 185 to 181. Steele Hurton out front. 13 minutes, 10 seconds remain.
And on your fast girl start line for the Brawl Stars, number 22, Just Wing It, I believe her first time with the star for today's game. She'll be up against the veteran of the Steele Hurton, Hurricane Heather.
We've seen a lot from Wing It in the pack today. Very effective with the sweep out from the tripod position. So perhaps using Wing It's aggressive skills to shoulder through the pack is just what Ann Arbor needs to get on top. Lead to Just Wing It. Hurricane Heather about a half a lap behind. Ann Arbor pivot to the penalty box, joined by Sophia from Steele Hurton. Pack picking up some speed, headed into turn two. Ann Arbor trying to deter Hurricane Heather. Is it enough? Forcing a cutting, the track penalty on Hurricane Heather. Power jam for Just Wing It, who is hit to the outside by Steele Hurton, able to come back on that back stretch and emerge through the pack, picking up another 5.
Popping fresh in the penalty box for a direction of gameplay as Just Wing It rolls on into the inside straightaway for another scoring pass.
Despite the efforts of Steele Hurton to take out Just Wing It, that jammer is solid. 10 points up for Wing It thus far. Both teams using the brace two-wall defense. Hurricane Heather back out there, juking around, able to put 4 points up for Steele Hurton. Turns out Just Wing It's efforts paid off. 12 points to Steele Hurton's 4 points on that last jam, taking Ann Arbor out on top again, 193 to 189. Whew, Vince.
Banshee, a quick update on the whiteboard for the Steele Hurton. Number 2, Raven, has fouled out with 7 box trips. Leanne Grohl still sitting on 6. Bone Crusher, number 82, also on 6. Sapphire sitting on 5. Poppin' Fresh sitting on 5. Incredible penalty force game by the Brawl Stars as they'll send out the monster, number 811, Tiramisu, with the star.
And Tiramisu's opponent, Gillespie, number 12, Steele Hurton. Both teams utilizing rotating braced two-wall strategy. Gillespie getting caught up manages, with a little help from number 10, that would be Ada Bloodlace, the Steelheart and captain, is set free. Lead to steal her and could be just what they need.
Gillespie, only her second lead jammer call of the day, but doing it in style with a nice spin around on the outside lane. 4 points, it calls it off.
It was a beautiful one-legged pass.
And let's take a look at that scoreboard, Banshee. What do we have?
We have a tie game, folks. 193 all. Whew. Like I say, roller derby, it's like camping. Intense.
I see what you did there.
You're welcome. 9 minutes, 35 seconds remain. And it appears we have a nice empty penalty box starting the jam. Your jammers are Snarkalepsy in yellow for Steel Hurt and Slamuel L. Jackson in black for the Ann Arbor Brawl Stars. Pack getting divvied up a bit. We're not seeing those two very clear formations. Snarkalepsy taking lead. Meanwhile, Jack still in the pack. Jack stashing the star, coming up against Steel Hurton's defense. And Hurton indeed.
And even the Kraken trying to break up that brace diamond still can't spring free. Narcolepsy on that, the pivot. Number 25, Allie McKill, reports to the penalty box. Believe that for a direction of gameplay, that her third box trip of the game.
A big hit appears we have a high block assessed to Sophia.
And that's Lamuel L. Jackson, a little slow to get up, feeling it just a little bit, but she will get up on her own power. EMT's coming over to where she's at in turn number 4.
And while they deal with assisting our skater with medical attention, glad to see that she's able to get back over to her bench if needed. And we're going to touch on the penalties. We currently have two skaters on Steel Hurt, and one being Grohl and the other being Bone Crusher, 6 penalties. I apologize. We also have a third, Sophia. That was number 6.
And what you can't see in the penalty box, apparently at the end of that jam, Slamuel L. Jackson receiving a penalty, I believe that one for a low block, her fourth box trip, because she is out being injured. The rules require somebody in her same position to take her place. That's why you see 811 Tiramisu in the penalty box, even though she was not that jammer that last jam.
Correct, because Jax will need to sit for at least 3 jams. Mm-hmm.
And I believe the Steel Hurton doing the Daniel Bryan yes chant.
No, it's not yes. That's Yins.
Yins.
That's Yins. Yins, they're speaking Pittsburghese and cheering for Steel Hurton. Yins, Y-I-N-Z to be exact.
That's why I've never been to Pittsburgh.
I've had the pleasure of playing against a Steel Hurton before, so it's a good time. But speaking of, that is Hurricane Heather jamming unopposed due to that recent penalty, facing the braced 3 wall, hitting the floor near the outside line. Dipping around, able to maneuver, lead to Hurricane Heather.
Hurricane Heather now 2 of 4 lead jammer calls in the period, but what an amazing talent for finding that lane either in lane 1 or lane 4, outside, inside, just sneaking on by, Banshee.
Yes, and Tiramisu has returned to the track, fighting against the Steel Hurt in defense, pushing it out, however, picking up a forearm call coming around the outside. So giving an additional 30 seconds to Hurricane Heather, capitalizing on some points, taking Steel Hurton past the double century mark. That last pass put them at 202. In turn 3, Ann Arbor doing their darndest to hold Hurricane Heather, taking her to the inside line, all the way to the outside line, forces a call off.
Hurricane Heather saying to the jammer, didn't you see my left arm up and down? That is the jammer call-off signal, right? Almost like saying to the bench for Steel Hurton, is it me? Am I doing this wrong here? What am I doing?
Well, you know, sometimes we get a little animated. Setting up again for the solo start. That is 333 River Kicks for Steelheart in the pack, lining up a little closer to the pivot line. Ann Arbor able to drive River Kicks to the infield, cycle back to the jammer line area. Tiramisu back on the track. It appears going right back to the penalty box. That was a cutting the track penalty assessed to Tiramisu. And it's something we've commented on after the prior games for Ann Arbor was the timing of their jammer penalties, really to their detriment, not so much the frequency. And in this case, it could be crucial. 5 points up for River Kicks, coming around the back of the pack once again to forced out by Ann Arbor's defense on the outside line. Turn three forces the call. 9 points to Steelheart in 216 to 193. 5.5 minutes remain.
And special thank you to Quick from the Rydell family. When you need to roll quick, think Quick, K-W-I-K. Quick bearings where precision meets performance. And you can look at Radar, the new Radar Halo wheel. Achieve world-class edging without sacrificing grip from the Rydell family.
Gillespie with the power start. Up the inside line, driven to the infield by Michelle Obamia. Able to escape the effort on the inside line to send her out of bounds, picks up lead. Big sweeps coming from the Steel City offense. Tiramisu returns, pushing out Steel Hurton's pack. Gillespie against the four wall. Actually, more of a cube coming from Ann Arbor Brawl Stars. 4 points up for Steel Hurton, 220 to 193.
Steel Hurton on the last, let's call it, four jams, currently on a 27-0 run. And that 27-0 run brought to you by Powerdyne. Cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance. That's Powerdyne from the Rydell family.
Hurricane Heather is back on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Her opponent, Just Wing It, doling out a little jammer aggression from the get-go. Met with Steel Hurton's defense as they took the back line. Hurricane Heather leading her favor as Just Wing It taken to the infield, drawn all the way back to the jammer line.
Hurricane Heather now 4 of 6 lead jammer calls in the second period. Currently about the fourth in all scores with 55 points, but a plus minus of 46. And thought somebody was going to the box, apparently not. Oh, no, wait, it is confirmed. And unfortunately for the Brawl Stars, the wheels continue to metaphorically fall off as the fourth straight jam where they've had a jammer in the box.
Yes, and Just Wing It picking up a cutting the track penalty. Hurricane Heather pushing up in the back stretch up on Ann Arbor's Brawl Star defense coming into turn four. Up on the tiptoes, using that apex to her advantage. 10 points so far. I just heard someone in the crowd yell, jammer sandwich.
Jammer sandwich.
Sounds fantastic. I always talk about the awkward blocker sandwich as you're working on a jammer, but jammer sandwich. I don't know how delicious that might be. Perhaps pretty tasty to some tough blockers. Hurricane Heather getting past the two wall up front, manages to pick up, no penalty for her.
That one will go against number 63, Jackie Obash's, for an, I believe, an out of play or a low block, regardless, her fourth box trip of the game.
Apex jump with a current tally of 24 points for Hurricane Heather. 2 minutes, 3 seconds remain, putting Steel Hurton on top, 244 points over Ann Arbor's 193. She ain't going out like that. putting the points on the board. That is Hurricane Heather for Steelheart, and rightfully smiling.
And an update on the whiteboard with under a minute 42 left in regulation for the Brawl Stars. Scream 886 has fouled out. Jackie O'Bash is 63 with five box trips. Lethal, number three with five box trips. Jen Price, 121 with four. Slammy L. Jackson with four. A lot of ink there on that whiteboard, Banshee.
Yes. And, it happens when there's a very aggressive physical game. Speaking of, Snarkalepsy, able to evade a big swinging hit from an Ann Arbor defender. Terror Misu back on the track, fighting a wall of one. Snarkalepsy met with a two wall, attempting to put the brakes on in turn three. Snarkalepsy steps right around. Not only your lead jammer, but 4 points up. Termisu on her initial scoring, met with a two wall of Steelheart. And Nick Rolfeliak able to hold her for a few seconds, but 4 points up for Ann Arbor.
McRafilia blocking out of play, now her fifth box trip of the game as period clock under 30 seconds.
And as a result of all the penalties, we have the 3-2 pack advantage. Oh, that just changed to even out. 3-on-3 blockers. Each team still with one blocker in the penalty box. Termisu pushing the Steelheart and tripod in the front. Snarkalepsy working on Ann Arbor in the back. Packs now hanging out between turns 1 and 2.
And period clock has expired. Snarkalepsy checks with the bench, confirms, calls it off, and that will be your unofficial final. The Steelheartin will get 258, the Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars 205, and Steel City will come from behind to get the win.
What a way to go out for Steelheartin, 258-205, and great efforts by Ann Arbor. Lots of ground covered for them at this tournament, their debut Division I playoffs. And Steelheart in the story, showing that your vet skaters, you know, Hurricane Heather, Leanne Grohl, really just putting it all out on the track. Incredible, Vince.
Indeed. We didn't see Leanne Grohl after that second jam, but her teammates able to do it for her. She kept on the six box trips and stayed in the game. An incredible scoring run in the second half. Steelheartin outscoring the Brawl Stars 143-61. And the Brawl Stars held scoreless 7 of the 8 final jams of that game. Incredible.
Steelheartin's collective hustle, proof that teamwork makes the dream work. The story before you here at the 2016 International WFTDA Playoffs.
Well, credit to Coach Daddy. He's all about making good decisions. They made excellent decisions in that second period. Only two jammer penalties compared to 1, 2, 3, a multitude of jammer penalties for the Brawl Stars. A tough break for the Brawl Stars. We've seen it so many times this weekend. They play so well, but they don't quite get to that next step. And sometimes, unfortunately, like we saw with, I believe it was Columbia, the wheels just metaphorically fall off in the second period.
Yeah, and this is something, it's a growth opportunity for Ann Arbor, but well done, Brawl Stars. Steelheartin, quite the way to go out and finish the tournament. And it'll be great to see what we have next. Don't forget, we have a social media that you can interact with us. Great Twitter feed live during the games. Hashtag talk to WFTDA. Do we have something from one of our viewers?
Well, I believe we've got a viewer who's mentioning that the blockers of color are getting work done on the track, but kind of wishing if only those jammers could also stay on the track with them as well.
Right? But again, big shout-outs to A2D2, Ann Arbor Derby Dimes Brawl Stars, and Steel City Steelheartin. It's been a good one, and I can't wait to see what more we have ahead of us on day three of the Division I playoffs, live here in Columbia, South Carolina. I'm Beautiful Banshee, here with Vince Hannity. And do we have some post-game?
I believe we're about to toss it to Sissy Splasek, who is with a retiring and triumphant Leanne Grohl and Hurricane Heather.
Fantastic. Sissy?
Thanks, guys. That's right. I'm here with Leanne Grill and Hurricane Heather of Steel.
Hi.
Hi. So that was a big win. That was a huge win. A really intense game, came from behind, and were able to really put up a ton of points in the last few jams there. How did that feel?
Fantastic.
Absolutely amazing.
So I know there's been a lot of emotion going into this. I don't think it's any secret that one, y'all are sisters, and two, y'all are retiring after this. So what are you sort of feeling right now?
Crazy. Everything. Emotional. Like we're making a mistake, but at the same time, it's been a fantastic 10 years.
It's just time to give something else a try. And I know that Derby is always here. And you know, we are technically not retiring. We are taking a break for an undetermined amount of time.
Yes. I love it. Yeah, I mean, you never really leave Derby. It's always a part of you. And you know, as soon as you get that bug again, I think you'll be back on your skates. So I know the big thing with Steel City is, you know, y'all are this unit, this strong team that's doing this together, and that's a big thing for you. What do you have to say to the rest of your team right now?
We're still going to be there to support. We're going to be at every game. We're going to still be available for coaching and clinics. I plan on doing a jam skating school after this, and Derby people are definitely welcome.
And if you know, Steel City's always, always going to be a part of us. They can never get rid of us.
I love it. All right, and lastly, I'm from the South. What is the yins, and what is a yins, really?
Yins is like you all, you guys. We're really lazy in Pittsburgh, I guess, so we just like contract everything.
All right, I love it.
You guys of Pittsburgh.
All right, I love it.
One more time.
Yins, guys.
All right, everybody at home, you're here with Leanne Grohl and Hurricane Heather of Steel City. I'm Sissy Splasek.